Welcome friends to the Mathematics Made Manageable Mathematics Video Tutorial Series prepared by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, KVS at Mumbai. Reference material in all chapters of Class 12 Mathematics is available easily to all the students. The students are not able to gather necessary help from these material as students need detailed explanation of the solution steps, recollection of concepts required for the solution at required places, tips to do problems with slight changes, tips to reduce errors. The above needs of the students is taken care of at this tutorial series. Important concepts and solutions to NCERT textbook questions in each chapter is prepared using PowerPoint presentation and the same is converted into video. The concept and solutions are supported by necessary narrations. The tutorial is only a supplementary material to students and it cannot replace the classroom teaching by an experienced teacher. Okay, the PowerPoint presentations with the solutions can be downloaded from the link given at the bottom of this video. The link to the PPT and also link to the PPT with the narration is given at the bottom of the video which you are watching. Welcome to Chapter 5, Continuity and Differentiability. The topic is Derivative of Inverse Trigonometric Function. Here, we are going to see the techniques to find the derivative of inverse trigonometric functions and the solution to the exercise 5.3 of NCERT textbook. Before we start, let us recollect the properties of inverse trigonometric functions which will be highly useful for us to find the derivative. Sine inverse of sine x is x. Cosecant inverse of cosecant x is x, cos inverse of cos x is x, secant inverse of secant x is also x, and tan inverse of tan x is x, and cot inverse of cot x is x. And sometimes we may get the sine inverse of cos also. There we will use the idea that sine pi by 2 minus x is cos x, cos pi by 2 minus x is sine x, like that. We will be making use of that so that the sine inverse of sine we used to get. Suppose if we get sine inverse of cos, we will try to convert it into sine inverse of sine also. Let us continue with the properties again. Sine inverse of 1 by x is cosecant inverse x. Suppose you have a sine inverse of some reciprocal, it can be converted into cosecant inverse. Then cos inverse of 1 by x is secant inverse x. Tan inverse of 1 by x is cot inverse x. And we can have in the other way also. Suppose if it is cosecant inverse of 1 by x, then it is sine inverse x. Suppose if you are having cosecant inverse x, it can be converted into sine inverse x by simply doing the reciprocal of whatever the quantity inside the bracket. Similarly, secant inverse can be converted into cos inverse and cot inverse can be converted into tan. Let us continue with the properties once again. Sine inverse of minus x, suppose you get some minus sign inside, then it will be minus of sine inverse x. Tan inverse of minus x is minus tan inverse x. And cosecant inverse of minus x is minus cosecant inverse x. But whenever you are having any negative inside that bracket, then that can be simplified making use of this property which we have already seen in inverse trigonometric function chapter. We'll continue. Cos inverse of minus x is not minus cos inverse x, it is pi minus cos inverse x. Similarly, secant inverse of minus x is pi minus secant inverse x. And cot inverse of minus x is pi minus cot inverse x. Therefore, we are having two sets where sine inverse of minus x, cos inverse, cosecant inverse of minus x and tan inverse of minus x, they lead to minus of that. But cos inverse, secant inverse and cot inverse will lead to pi minus of that, pi minus and pi minus. You have to remember it. It will be highly helpful for us to do simplifications. Let us continue with the properties once again. If you come across sine inverse x plus cos inverse x, it is pi by 2. Similarly, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2. then cosecant inverse x plus secant inverse x is equal to pi by 2. This idea is derived from the fact that sine of pi by 2 minus x is cos x, then tan of pi by 2 minus x is cot x, then cosecant inverse of pi by 2 minus x is secant x. Similarly, you can have cos of pi by 2 minus x and cot of pi by 2 minus x and secant of pi by 2 minus x. It is being used there. Therefore, you have to remember that what are the pairs, sine inverse and cos inverse, tan and cot, and cosecant and secant. When you add those inverse trigonometric function, if the angle is same, suppose if the value is same, x, 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 then it will be pi by 2. Then one more property, this we will be using it while we are doing simplification. Tan inverse of x plus tan inverse y is tan inverse x plus y by 1 minus xy. Then tan inverse minus, if you have, it will be tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy. Please see, plus sign comes in the numerator for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, and plus sign comes in the denominator for tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. These are the formulae already we have discussed. This formula is derived from tan of x plus y, and the second one is derived from tan of x minus y. This will be highly useful whenever you are doing any simplifications. Similarly, 2 tan inverse x is sine inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square. If you want to convert tan inverse into sine inverse. Similarly, you can convert tan inverse into cos inverse. Similarly, you can convert tan inverse into tan inverse. These 3 formulae are derived from the formulae of sine 2x and cos 2x and tan 2x. The formula of multiple angles. Making use of it, we can have a connection between tan inverse and sine inverse. Suppose if you are having this type of simplifications, it can be used so that that differentiation will be simple for us. While you are doing the differentiation of inverse trigonometric function, either you have to use the formula directly. For example, you have sine inverse x, there is a formula, cos inverse x, there is a formula, tan inverse x, there is a formula. Sometime what will happen, we will be always try to reduce the inverse trigonometric function to the simplest form. Suppose you have tan inverse of inside square root 1 plus root x minus 1 minus root x, like that very big expression is there. By directly making use of the formula will be little bit tedious. For what we will do, if it is possible, we will use the formula directly. Otherwise, we will use proper substitution to reduce the inverse trigonometric function to its simplest form. This was already discussed in your chapter of inverse trigonometric function of reducing it to simplest form by putting some value for x. For example, it may be tan theta, it may be sine theta, it may be secant theta, it may be cos 2 theta, and so on. Then after that, what you do is, do resubstitution if substitution done. For example, you have put x is equal to tan theta. Do the simplification. Don't forget to put theta is equal to tan inverse x and then do the differentiation. This you should be a little bit careful. Because when you do the simplification, the final answer may be 2 theta. All of you will be very happy because I got 2 theta, therefore differentiation is 2. So it is totally wrong. When you do substitution, you have to do resubstitution. Once again, I repeat, when you do substitution, you have to do resubstitution. After resubstitution only, you have to do the differentiation. Okay, please note down the steps. You can use the formula directly, but suppose if the expression is very huge, definitely there will be a scope for substitution and reduce it to simplest form. If you are doing any substitution, after it is reduced to the simplest form, don't do the differentiation directly. You have to do the resubstitution and then do the differentiation. You can remember like this, I have to differentiate only with respect to x. Suppose if it is 2 theta, you can't differentiate it with respect to x. You have to convert that theta in terms of x, then only you have to do the differentiation. This you have to remember while you are doing your problem. Let us have one problem now. Y is equal to sine inverse x. Its formula is dy by dx is equal to 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Suppose your problem is given to you like this. Let us try to use this formula by making use of chain rule. It is 1 upon 1 minus root 1 minus square root of 1 minus x square the whole square, and then dy by dx of root x. D by dx of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Therefore, the answer will be 1 by 2 root x into root of 1 minus x. So these types of problem can come directly to you because we are making use of the formula for y is equal to sine inverse x derivative. What is sine inverse of tan x? It will be 1 by, in place of x, you are having tan x. Therefore, 1 minus tan x the whole square into d by dx of tan x, making use of chain rule. D by dx of tan x is secant square. Therefore, the answer is secant square x by root 1 minus tan square x. For you remember now, the formula for sine inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Whatever in inside the sine inverse x, the square of it. Formula for y is equal to cos inverse x is dy by dx is minus 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Let us see what is cos inverse of 3 minus 2x. It will be minus 1 upon 1 minus that 3 minus 2x the whole square into differentiation of 3 minus 2x. 3 minus 2x is a very normal expression. You can differentiate it 0 minus 2. Therefore, the answer is 2 upon square root of 1 minus 3 minus 2x the whole square. Let us take one more problem in cos inverse. Cos inverse of tan x, for example, it is minus 1 upon root 1 minus tan x the whole square. D by dx of tan x is secant square x. Therefore, you can write it directly. Minus secant square x upon root 1 minus tan square x. So these are some problem where making use of the formula of cos inverse x, we are extending it chain rule. Differentiation of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Suppose you have tan inverse of x square. How to do it? It is 1 upon 1 plus x square the whole square into differentiation of x square, making use of chain rule. Differentiation of x square is 2x, therefore it is 2x upon 1 plus x power 4. Very famous expression. Let us see what is tan inverse of sin x. Same idea. It is 1 upon 1 plus sin x the whole square into differentiation of sin x, making use of chain rule. Differentiation of sin x is cos x, or cos x upon 1 plus sin square x. While you are doing problems, we will be trying to do some substitutions, as I told you earlier. But there are certain substitutions which, by seeing the expressions inside the tan inverse bracket or sine inverse bracket, that inverse trigonometric function, the bracket, by seeing the expressions, you can go for some substitutions. But these substitutions will definitely work out in most of the problem. You see a square plus x square as one of the terms, then you put x is equal to a tan theta, so that it will become a square plus a square tan square theta. A square comes out, it will become a square into secant square theta. If it is inside the square root, that square root will go. Okay. If you have a square minus x square as one of the term, then you put x is equal to a sin theta. You have to remember, if it is 1 plus x square, it is a x is equal to tan theta only. If it is 4 minus x square, it should be x is equal to 2 sin theta. According to the value of a, you have to fix it. Suppose you find x square minus a square. This is x is equal to a secant theta is a suggested substitution to reduce the problem. Sometime you may get root 1 plus x and root 1 minus x. Now I think it will be very difficult for us. Our intention is to remove the square root normally, so that the differentiation will be easy. Here you should put x is equal to cos 2 theta. Some book will tell cos theta, but if you put cos 2 theta, you will avoid submultiple angle. Root 1 plus cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta, and root 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta. Therefore, that square root will go, then only that constant will come out. As you know, in differentiation, the constant is not going to trouble you much. Then, suppose in the same way, inside the square root, you have 1 plus x square. You see, previously you had a square plus x square, I have written there in the first one. It is not inside square root, it is simply a square plus x square. Now, if the same a square plus x square, that is 1 plus x square, is inside the square root. Suppose if 1 minus x square is inside the square root. If it is not inside the square root, you can try with x is equal to a sin theta, because it is no square root is there. But don't try that particular one here. Here, you have to go for x square is equal to cos 2 theta. The same thing as you expressed in the earlier one. If it is 1 plus cos 2 theta, it is 2 cos square theta. If it is 1 minus cos 2 theta, it will be 2 sin square theta. Therefore, the square root will go. Therefore, this is one easy way of remembering. A square plus x square, a tan theta. A square minus x square, a sin theta. X square minus a square, a secant theta. If you see the expressions root 1 plus x and root 1 minus x, you should put x is equal to cos 2 theta. If you see the expressions root 1 plus x square and root 1 minus x square, it should be x square is equal to cos 2 theta. Sometimes if you see some expression which looks like the multiple angle formula, sin 2 theta, cos 2 theta, tan 2 theta, sin 3 theta, cos 3 theta, tan 3 theta, accordingly you have to decide what is the substitution so that the sin inverse of will get reduced. Shall we go for some problems now? Now I will go for a problem just for practice where no substitution but direct simplification. You see, root 1 minus cos x by root 1 plus cos x. I am afraid that I cannot do it directly. Therefore, I will go for substitution. I know that 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square and 1 plus cos 2 theta is 2 cos square. What will happen in the submultiple angle? It will be 2 sin square x by 2 and 2 cos square x by 2. Square root will go, root 2 will get cancelled. You will get sin x by 2 by cos x by 2. Therefore, it is tan x by 2. Tan inverse of tan is the same value will come. Therefore, it is x by 2. Here, I have not done any substitution. For no need for resubstitution. Directly, I am going for differentiation. Therefore, x by 2 differentiation is 1 by 2. Like this also, you can get some problems where direct substitution making use of trigonometric formulae, submultiple angle formulae, multiple angle formulae of sine, cos, tan, you can simplify the problem. Let us go for a problem where we need substitution. You are seeing a square minus x square. Therefore, I am going for trying that a is equal to sine theta. But before I go for that, let me check whether what is theta, because I want resubstitution. For theta is sine inverse x by a. Please check it in the beginning itself so that we have to do simplification, resubstitution and differentiation. Okay, tan inverse x upon root x square minus x square. I am putting x is equal to a sin theta upon a square minus a square sin square theta. Take a square outside inside the square root. It will become 1 minus sin square. Therefore, it is cos square. Therefore, the denominator will become a cos theta. Or you can simplify it. It is tan inverse of tan theta, which is theta. Now, you cannot do the differentiation directly. We have to go for resubstitution. Theta is sin inverse x by a. Therefore, differentiation of sin inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Therefore, it is 1 upon square root of 1 minus x by a the whole square into d by dx of x by a. D by dx of x by a differentiation is 1 by a. Whenever you are doing the simplification of this square root, it will be a square minus x square upon a square, that a will go to the top because inside the square root, therefore the answer is 1 upon root a square minus x square. Okay, now some simplification, if possible simplification you can make. You see this problem, what we have done? We have done simplification by making substitution. After simplification, resubstitution, then doing differentiation. Let us move on to problem number 9 in exercise 5.3. Once again, it is sine inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square. I am afraid that we cannot, no need to do it directly. Let us go for substitution. For 1 plus x square, it is x is equal to tan theta. A square plus x square, it is a tan theta. 1 plus x square, it is tan theta. Now I am fixing that what is theta for resubstitution. It is tan inverse x. I am putting the substitutions now. 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square. It is nothing but sine 2 theta. Sine 2 theta formula. It is 2 theta. Sine inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square. It is doing the resubstitution. It is 2 times tan inverse x. Now the problem is ready for differentiation. The answer is 2 upon 1 plus x square. Suppose if the same question is given as 2x upon 1 minus x square also. You can do the problem. It is not a problem for you. There you can put x is equal to tan theta once again. Then it may go to cos 2 theta formula. Sin inverse of cos 2 theta, you know how to convert it. Let us move on to question number 10. Dy by dx, if y is equal to tan inverse of 3x minus x cube by 1 minus 3x square. As I told you earlier, I think inside the bracket, it looks like the formula for tan 3 theta. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta. For now, you decide the substitution now. Put x is equal to tan theta here. but the substitution which I gave you as a list, that it will not fit into it, because there we have given only a square plus x square, a square minus x square, which are a little bit standard. But here inside the tan inverse, I am looking, it is just giving me the idea that it looks like the formula for tan 3 theta. For I am substituting now, 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square. It is tan inverse of tan 3 theta, for the answer is 3 theta. I should not do the differentiation now because I have done a substitution. Do the resubstitution. It is 3 times tan inverse x. It is 3 upon 1 plus x square. Very simple. But remember, there is a, you have to be very careful. Look at the term inside that inverse trigonometric function. Tan inverse of something. There, if you look like it, tan 3 theta formula or cos 2 theta formula or sin 2 theta formula, then accordingly you select the substitution. Let us move on to the next question. Y is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. I think here also for 1 plus x square I told you that it should be x is equal to tan theta. For 1 minus x square it should be x is equal to sin theta. But remember, the term inside the bracket, it looks like a formula for cos 2 theta, because I have a formula for cos 2 theta, 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. Okay, you got the idea now. For I take x is equal to tan theta now. For theta is tan inverse x, I keep it ready. Now I am going for cos inverse of 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. For it is cos inverse of cos 2 theta. Therefore, it is 2 theta. Now I am not ready for differentiation. I have to do the resubstitution. It is 2 times tan inverse x. Therefore, the final answer is 2 upon 1 plus x square. You are seeing the previous problem and this problem, the final differentiation is same, even though the given function is different. Let us move on to question number 12. Find dy by dx if y is equal to sine inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. When I see this expression 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square, it resembles the formula for sin 2 theta or cos 2 theta, whatever may be. Let us try to find it. Sin inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. This 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square resemble formula for multiple angles. Well, let us try to put x is equal to tan theta. It will make it as 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. Theta is equal to tan inverse x. Let us try to put sin inverse of 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. All of you know that this is the formula for cos 2 theta. Cos 2 theta is having 4, 2 cos square theta minus 1, 1 minus sin square theta, then 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. And it is a sin inverse of cos of 2 theta. Now, we know that it is sin inverse of sin only, we can directly write it as 2 theta. Here we can't write. But we can use this idea that cos is always sin of pi by 2 minus theta. For cos is always sin of pi by 2 minus whatever the theta there. Therefore, it can be written as sin of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. It is also resembles that it will go to the first quadrant. In first quadrant, everything is positive. For 90 minus theta, therefore, it is in the first quadrant. Everything is positive. For 90, sin will become cos. Therefore, it is cos 2 theta. Now, sin inverse of sin is the same thing for pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Now, also, I am not ready for differentiation. I have to do the resubstitution. For it is pi by 2 minus 2 into tan inverse x. Therefore, for pi by 2, differentiation is 0. And tan inverse x, the differentiation is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Therefore, it is minus 2 upon 1 plus x square. Once again, a problem where we have to find problem number 13. Dy by dx if y is equal to cos inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square. It resembles the multiple angle formula for sin 2 theta, which is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square. Well, let us try now. Let us put x is equal to tan theta and theta is equal to tan inverse x. Now I am substituting 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta inside the bracket. Therefore, it will become cos inverse of sin 2 theta, because sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta, one formula. Another formula is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square. But once again, cos inverse of cos, we can directly write the angle. But here in terms of sine, it can be converted into cos. by making use of sine theta is nothing but cos of pi by 2 minus theta. Therefore, it is cos of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Cos inverse of cos is the same thing. Therefore, pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Here also, I am not ready for differentiation now. I have to do the resubstitution. Pi by 2 minus 2 times tan inverse x. When I do the differentiation, pi by 2 differentiation is 0. Tan inverse x differentiation is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Therefore, I got the final answer as minus 2 upon 1 plus x square. Highly interesting. The answer for the problem number 12 and problem number 13 are the same, but the function is entirely different. There we got y is equal to sine inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. Here we got y is equal to cos inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square. But both of them give you the same answer as pi by 2 minus 2 times tan inverse x. Let us move to question number 14. I think inside the bracket it looks like the sine 2 theta formula. Let us try. We know that when it is 1 minus x square you are seeing, then you have to put x is equal to sine theta. But be careful, as root 1 minus x square, if it is there in so many places, then we will try with cos 2 theta now. But here don't do that. X is equal to sine theta, theta is sine inverse x. When you do the substitution, sine inverse of 2 sine theta into root 1 minus sine square, root 1 minus sine square theta is root cos square theta, which is cos theta. For you will get sine inverse of 2 sine theta cos theta, sine 2 theta, therefore the answer is 2 theta. I am not ready for differentiation. Do the resubstitution. It is 2 times sine inverse x, therefore you got 2 upon root 1 minus x square. Here, substitution done by looking the term inside that sine inverse, which looks like the formula for sine 2 theta. Let us continue with dy by dx, y is equal to secant inverse of 1 by 2 x square minus 1. Here we will put x is equal to cos theta because 2 cos square theta minus 1, we are having a formula that is cos 2 theta. Therefore, we are putting x is equal to cos theta, theta is equal to cos inverse x. For secant inverse of 1 upon 2 cos square theta minus 1, 2 cos square theta minus 1 is cos 2 theta. For secant inverse of 1 upon cos 2 theta, 1 upon cos 2 theta is nothing but secant 2 theta. Secant inverse of secant, that whatever the value is the same thing, therefore 2 theta. But we are not ready for differentiation. Do the resubstitution. We have put x is equal to cos theta, therefore theta is cos inverse x. Therefore, final answer is minus 2 upon root 1 minus x square. Because the differentiation of cos inverse x is minus 1 upon root 1 minus x square.